All right, let's start. Welcome to some burning wheel. There's a special setting here today with a bunch of water and some men. So let's introduce yourselves. Let's start with Ollie.
Yeah, Ollie, playing Mr. Axeman, burly sailor dude.
Burly sailor dude. Yeah. What sort of man is he?
He's a man who likes stabbing things and sailing in large amounts of alcohol.
He sails in alcohol, okay.
He sails in alcohol. Dunsten
boy?
Yeah, I'm playing Dunsten. I'm Jeeves. He was born aboard a ship. And he generally loves being aboard ships, swimming, and diving down for salvage at the bottom of the sea.
Bottom of the sea? Mr. Bones?
I am playing Freako, a stocky man. I'm frail already! I'm playing Freako. I am a rather sallow, completely unseaworthy torturer who once was broken upon the rack by some rather unfortunate bandits, learned the tricks of the trade, and basically turned a frown upside down via the medium of making people hurt a lot.
Annoyed man. Very annoyed man. Well... This setting is a bit peculiar. I've talked about it on the stream before, but in case someone has not heard about it before, it kind of, think of this big vortex, or rather the eye of a storm, where it's calm in the middle. This is a bunch of islands inside a round bit where, I'm gonna draw a little bit here, very fine. Like, never mind the background, like this. And out here, there's this big vortex. All the water in the middle is completely calm. This big vortex here.
Mm-hmm.
And out here, there's mist. And this is quite a large area. There's a lot of islands. The one we're looking at right now is about here. And anyone... No one remembers what's outside, but it is sort of implied that everyone living on these islands came from outside at some point. They washed in or something like that. Every now and then, there's no trees that grow here, only bushes and crap they can use for rope and things like that. Some seaweed that's edible and other sorts of reeds and stuff, but nothing wood. Or there's no ore either.
Is there weather or is it always still?
There's no weather in recent memory.
Just fucking
but
hot.
Is there wind?
No.
So that we can...
Only when they start getting out towards the rim. A skilled crew can go out onto the rim and actually sort of ride the vortex and then slingshot out of it further down by rowing. But if they get out into the mist, the current gets stronger and stronger the further out you get. And at some point, no matter how good you are at rowing, you won't be able to get out. And if you disappear into the mist, you're not seen again.
Which could be a good thing, because you might end up somewhere nicer. But...
I guess.
Silent Hill water version.
The sun's always in the sky, always in the middle of the sky. When it turns to what we would think of as night, it turns into this thing that looks like a slit, kind of like a cat's eye. Kind of like if you imagine two half moons mirrored on the middle, sort of like that. This doesn't seem odd to anyone because that's all you've ever known. And there are no animals that have eyes like that, so the sort of what's it called? Relation has not really sprung up.
It doesn't seem like a cat's eye to us because we've never seen a cat.
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Just seems like a dark moon, a dark sun.
Yeah. A dark sun. Good
The sound of the GM going, how dare you hit upon a plot point, you fucker.
No, that's alright. Let's call it that. Dark Sun. That's night. Okay, so... The only source of wood and iron comes from the outside. And there'll be bits of flotsam and wrecks or bits of things that you're not sure what is sometimes float in from the outside. And two of you have worked such crews that go out there and get some of those.
See.
That would be Dunsten and Axeman.
See.
Axeman as a rower, mainly, and Dunsten as a diver.
See.
The greasy torturer has has been mainly employed with... there are certain bandits fucking around out there, looking to loot the boats on their way back. Since there's no current, everyone rows everywhere. And the boats are not always streamlined. Some of them are just round and weird. Torturer Man has sort of gotten some of those bandits they've captured and slapped them around a little bit. And sometimes, with luck, figured out where other bandits are, so...
How very fucking dare you. Skill, sir, skill.
Well, what's your skill again?
Four, isn't it? Hang on a second.
Oh, four is masterful, so...
Oh, no, what am I talking about here? Fuck it, think two.
Okay, two is kind of average. So, with kind of average
he
has...
Torture, four.
With great skill, he has sometimes coaxed information out of them, so that sometimes there would be safe passage from the bandits, because
they
would know where they are.
Bob!
Last time...
How do you spell that?
Last time he had someone under the knife was not such a case, and the previous crew rode right out and got slain and got robbed. The superiors are kind of salty with him about this. Of course, it was no fault of his own, because more than likely the bandit was told a bunch of shit by the other bandits in case this would happen. But still, Fricko's supervisor is not too happy about this. So, spirit of people building shit cannons that blew up constantly, and then afterwards had to sit on the cannon while it fired the first time, Fricka has been sort of tasked with going out on the next one with the crew.
Yes, sort of, because I'm totally okay with this.
Maybe he'll do his job properly before
maybe
then.
He'll die horribly.
He's been told to go out there as a rower, which he, of course...
I'm sorry, I'm just going to look at my physical attributes again and then laugh some more.
Ollie, a seasoned man in this, or what's his face, Axeman, a seasoned man in this, has been approached by some dudes and said, there's a thing out there and we'd like it looked at. It's pretty far out, so we will require a burly rower. This is Ollie. And we'll need a good diver as well. Luckily, Ollie has, it might not know him per se, but he's worked with Dunsten before, the skilled diver. So he's sort of... gotten you all together, and you have you borrowed a boat from wait, did you have a proper one, Ollie? He's dead.
BED dead.
He is imploded.
Mike was muted. Shit.
Stupid fuck.
I sadly do not have a boat. No,
you don't
I have
a boat.
Cottage.
Well, that's a boat.
That's a pretty nice boat. Actually,
any property in this is likely to be a boat, because
you've got a cottage boat. Fuck you all.
Well, that's not a hauler boat though. But Dunsten, your
it's a pretty boat.
Your what was it? Uncle Pixkin.
He's my cousin.
Oh, your cousin. Well, there's so much inbreeding going on here. So
he's also my uncle.
He's also his own dad. Yeah.
<He doesn't>.
Okay, so he has a boat. Suited for this, and he's allowed you to rent it for this occasion.
He's a fine chap.
He actually has two, and he's rented one of the smaller ones for a three-man crew. This is more of a survey mission than it is a an actual go out and get stuff back. So it's kind of a sleek, streamlined boat like this. It seats two rowers. It's kind of like a kayak, and then some shit in the middle here. So it's kind of burly. It's pretty good for good rowings and speed.
Yeah, taking an entire cottage on the water doesn't... Yeah, it would be a bit cumbersome, wouldn't it?
So. I'm just imagining like a thatched roof cottage just on pontines or something.
Well,
just sculling through the water.
I would search for one where Ray Mears makes the hide boat. That's sort of the idea I get. Bear in mind, it's only the burliest men that actually have... that actually have boats made of wood, because it's all flotsam and it's all very expensive. So most people have boats made from bones and hide from fish. Shark leather is pretty good. And pontoons, as you say. Floaty shit. That looks terrible.
So we row around in hollowed out sharks. We are the most metal fucking nation I've ever
heard. Something like
of.
That. You also wear the sharks. Okay, so you got this boat, and You're standing on the docks as much as they can be stood on. There's the boat there, and you're sort of you're getting a briefing from one of what's his face, his employers. Goddamn it! I keep forgetting your name, Fringo.
Frico.
Yeah. It's like there's some shit out there. You gotta have a look at for future salvage. It's probably nothing.
Oh god,
it's weird.
We're gonna get eaten, aren't we?
It's pretty deep down, but it's okay. It's probably get it all right. Here's some, we got some provisions, like for some fucking shit to eat, some dried fish, some seaweed, all you fucking need. Some skins of water. It's already in the boat.
But I'm not. My constitution is ill suited to the outdoor climate. You can't be serious.
He looks at you.
A man of my talent, surely I would be better suited. I've got no choice in this, have I?
The man is completely. He goes. He's a working man, and he assumes everyone is here to work. So he just doesn't understand what the fuck you're saying. It's like saying you don't live.
I look at Dunsten, just going to go. Is there some kind of patois I'm supposed to be speaking?
Well. The way it works is,
let's go.
The way it works is there's one seat in the middle where a dude sits, and then there's two rowing positions. You guys get to decide who gets to sit who.
Dibs middle.
I just jump straight into the front.
Yeah, good man. Ollie's got sea seniority here, so whenever you're in the boat, he will be boss.
Ah, shit.
At least that's what the shore guy says. Whatever you decide when you get to sea is up to you. You may bugger and whatever.
If it's official, then...
In with you, fucking...
I request a little captain's hat.
There's a very burly man with a club as well, and you know him, Fricko. He's one of the guys who've been sent to make sure you're seen off.
I flash him an incredibly sickly-looking smile as I pointedly just calmly step onto the boat.
He looks very happy. One of his friends was on the boat that died to bad information.
Yes. The smile just locks. All humour is gone.
Did we do your fate and shit, by the way?
I don't think so.
Okay, each of you, 3 fate and 2 persona. This is your starting shit. Bear in mind, every time you use a skill or you want to, you invoke a belief or an instinct, I can't keep track of all of it, make sure you mention it.
Ah,
I was like going, right. I'm pulling my cock out. It's not always implicit. Yes.
Internet.
You live a very sheltered life.
Thank you. Right. Ollie is handed a string of beads and set off his way. Sent on his way.
Pocket the beads. Fucking payment.
A pocket of... the beads are your instructions on where to go.
Oh shit! Yeah, of course. Forgot we don't speak normal moon language here.
No, awesome. For fuck's sake.
Hey, who robbed out my boat cottage?
Wasn't me.
We lost Luke again. Let's try and call him. For fuck's sake. Goddamn Skype.
Should we flip the coin so you know to edit this out?
Oh, there he is.
Sorry. Fucking Skype.
I hate you.
I'm sorry.
Okay, Ollie's handed a bunch of beads. The way writing is done in this is it's different colored and shaped beads and various things on the string. So you pretty much, you get a string of information and then you just read that shit. The string is his direction. It's the direction to the place. How's your bead reading?
Yeah, has one of us got read?
I'd probably hand it to Frisk and say, Frick.
Fucking Fisk.
Yes, Fisk was some Fisk.
I give it to Fricko and say, oi, you're not doing anything.
Bear in mind, a lot of this is very contextual. So, a layman with a yeoman's text is not going to be able to do much.
I just look at the beads and go, what?
Well, you can probably read. You should be able to, I think. To some
beads.
Degree. Yeah, read beads. That's how people read. There's no writing in this.
So fair enough. I had no idea that was the case. If that's the case, then beads.
Beads. Okay, yeah. Do you have the skill for it?
Beads.
I don't think I have a dedicated bead skill.
Oh. We probably should have taken steps to remedy this. Okay, you are here, by the way. All of this is a spider web of rigging lines with a bunch of ships. There's a town here, and the entire town is just all a bunch of ships all moored around this island. Lot of stuff on the actual mainland. Yeah, didn't none of you get beads? I remember that we decided that one of you would just have beads, or some of you would have beads, probably everyone but Dunsten.
Don't think
I mentioned, but sure, let's go for it.
Fuck's sake, okay. Have beads 1 and 2?
Right.
Torture Man probably reads more.
Mine is 1.
Okay, yours is 1, and yours is 2. Are you still here, Liam?
Yep.
Okay.
I'm right. Just assuming I'm not getting beads.
No, you're too young, sadly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I forgot to give you dice.
Dice, I'm about to talk about that.
Yeah, so you gotta figure out where to go. Oh man, I suck at this. I click the button. There we go.
Boutons.
Okay, so Dunsty gets his first.
So, thank you.
There, and Ollie.
Divium. Odd colour, but sure. Divium.
That's
sort of. Oh, fuck. I'm tripping out.
Trying to make them orange like your text.
Divium.
Sawbones, pink. Of course.
So, who wants to read the fucking beads?
I thought Sawbones had the beads, so.
Oh, yeah, of course I gave them to him and said,
yeah,
read
beads.
This. Ain't doing shit.
NP, oh, wait.
I can do some navigation stuff, if that's needed.
Nice. Yeah, so what you need to do here is something called a linked test. First, you need to read the beads. And it's an obs 1.
And, what is bead reading? What? Skill plus...
It's perception, I think.
Ah, okay.
So should I have like a latent skill in this, or is this beginner's luck?
No, you get 2 because you guy.
Oh,
would,
I get 2.
You guy would have had 2.
Add that as a skill.
Yeah. So you roll 2 dice.
Fucking.
Fucking badoo.
So I just roll 2 dice.
Yeah. Okay, you fuck it up massively. But
I haven't been out on the sea before.
Well, you're very confident. You give Ollie some directions. You figure...
Oh, shit.
You go sort of, yeah, it's probably this and that.
Damn direction.
By the yellow rock, 3 north of the sun or something like that.
Can I use C-wise? Can I C-wise check what he's doing?
Take
see whether it's
north,
completely ridiculous.
Past that cloud.
Well,
would I be able to use I was going to say either C-wise or seamanship to like know if he's talking out of his ass?
Try C-wise, whichever one of you wants to do it. By the way, since you rolled that, you get one.
Routine?
I think so, yeah, I'll put the thing out.
I was going to say it was D1, so I'd imagine it's...
There you go.
So C-wise plus...
Just C-wise, isn't it? You're not navigating yet. That's the shittiest roll. Okay, so you got C-wise, and you go like that. You get 1. And you think it, yeah, you might have heard of the place he was talking about, at least somewhat. You thought he was saying something about this little knob out here. And then a certain degree off that. Out here somewhere. You're fairly certain that's what he said. So are you going to try and get over there? Also, mark your thing down. That was an obs 2.
Yeah. Okay.
And it would have been Ops 1 if you had succeeded.
Already bringing the team down. Very nice.
Well, no one knows that.
No one knows. Wait, I'm doing my best.
That's the best kind.
Man. Did you note down your thing, Ollie?
Yeah, Ops 2, yeah?
Yeah. You press Alt on it.
I know, I'm just reading.
You, it was Ops 2, and you rolled 3 dice, so that's a difficult.
And difficult indeed.
Okay, did you want to do anything, Dunsty?
Can I check that also?
Sure.
That we're not going somewhere completely stupid is my intention.
Well, do you want to check the beads, or do you want to check, because you could try an unskilled bead.
I could. Well, I was thinking that I would just listen to the instructions and think, well, hang on, that's going to take us to stupid place.
Well, yeah, but you don't know where it is you're going, so...
Daddy.
Daddy.
Daddy. Daddy goo.
Wait for a second while he sorts the child. This is about the time where we lose back. Luke as well.
No, I'm here. if it crashes again, I will sign in on the web version of it rather than the app, because Windows 10 is a huge pile of shit.
It's true. So, right, what are you going to do? Dunsty, I mean.
Yeah.
I think he's back from kid wrangling.
Just imagine grabbing it by the ankle and winging it out the door. Yeah. Away with you!
Beat it, you slag.
That's what they're for, right?
I guess. I guess he's not there.
I think he's having a nap.
This angers me slightly.
I think Dunstan's had a stroke.
Sorry, yes.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
What was I doing? I was going to see if we were going to go somewhere completely stupid.
Yeah, but you have no reference for where you're meant to go, so that would not mean anything. But try rolling your thing anyway.
Okay.
What are you rolling?
Rolling my thing. I'm not sure. C-wise.
Okay.
I have 1 in C-wise, so...
Okay, roll your C-wise. It's an Obs 3.
What am I... Sorry?
It's an Obs 3.
Alright.
Because they've fucked up consecutively, so the Obs keep going up.
Getting harder and harder to get yourselves out of the hole.
By the way, if anyone out there watching this is wondering, the way this works is that they have to get successes over the obstacle. Anything above 4 and above is a success. So when they're rolling the dice, it's 50-50 per dice. Their skills determine how many dice they roll. So now that
I'm still rather confused by this. So how many dice am I rolling then?
Well, what skill do you have?
1.
Then you roll 1 dice.
Okay.
And you need to get 3 successes.
Right.
It's over fucked.
Yeah.
You can use Persona, you can use other shit, but right now, all it's going to do is it's going to give you a challenging test.
Right, exactly. I might as well just give it a try. I can always explode the 6s.
Fantastic. Okay. You get your challenging test.
That even rolls.
You get your challenging test and you think it sounds fantastic. They're completely on the right track. This is, you're going to go.
So I say that, awesome, guys. It seems like a really right track here.
I grunt my approval and start fucking rowing.
Yeah, you start rowing, so okay.
I stand on the prow of the ship and thrust my groin backwards and forwards as if I had a golden cogpiece on.
Well, that didn't carry over from the last session, sadly.
I said as if.
Oh, is he as if? I see, okay.
He's imagining himself in a past life.
How do you feel about this man in a way, Ollie?
I feel I mentioned to him if he doesn't get the fuck out of the way, I'm going to shove him overboard.
Oh. Sorry.
You're in my fucking face, shoving your ass in my eyes. Ain't good for
in
directions.
In my grill you are. Oh, fuck.
Sorry,
you must.
Did I forget to wipe?
Gross. I assume there's a lot of loincloth going on in this setting. I think Ollie's probably the only one that's properly dressed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Torture is probably sitting there.
I have some clothes.
But are you wearing them?
Well, yes.
Oh, okay, carry on.
Oh, God.
Right, so roll your rowing. The two of you rowing.
Yes.
To you as well, Fricko. That's a beginner's luck. It's an... Well, this is just to determine speed.
What am I rolling against?
Do you have rowing?
Oh, I don't have rowing, so it's just one die.
No. Beginner's luck, you roll the stat that it's based off, and rowing is speed, I believe. Isn't it, Ollie?
Yes, I believe so.
I'm fair enough, then three.
Is your speed three? Fucking hell.
Where is it?
Oh, that's two successes.
That's all right. So yeah, you get out of port fairly fine. Okay, so now that you've done that, you go to skills being learned, and you write rowing, and there's a place that says I think it is. Let me just find it. Skills being learned. It says aptitude. Where it says aptitude, you write 7.
Fair enough.
That means you have to get 7 dots in that fucking thing before you get the skill.
Sorry, I went fucking weird there. My internet went balked. Say that again. Ooh. On learning skills?
Not you. You have rowing already. You just get the tick for a skill.
Does that start with a routine tick then, or...?
No, it doesn't have a routine tick, it just has ticks.
So, do I start with a tick because I've just started learning, or...?
You start with a tick because you've done it once.
That's what I was thinking.
You need 7 of them.
Sure.
To learn it.
Here we go, lovely.
Yes. Okay, so you're learning that. Ollie's, you get... that was an OBS 1, so you get a...
routine, no?
Yes, in rowing.
I'm just imagining Freako's just kind of flapping at the water eventually. Ollie's character just kind of grabs him by the arms and goes, no,
yeah, just
in
slowly,
the fucking water. Out.
Slowly going in a circle.
I give you some tips, but I haven't got rowing either, so
right.
I don't know how to row.
3 people in a boat on a seafaring nation, one of them knows how to row.
Well,
yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I feel very fucking valuable right now.
How have we survived?
Well, we live in the digital age, right? We all know how to use computers, but are any of us really good at it?
No.
Well,
yeah,
there you go.
Well, I don't think you can really compare a computer to a boat.
Sure.
Why not?
A rudimentary shark skin canoe does not compare, technologically speaking, to a fucking laptop.
No, laptops are for women.
Throw it.
Anyway, you end up here and you think you're in the right position.
I thought it just came on the board.
What do we see around us?
Water.
Can you hear that?
Water, yes.
No. There's some guy bellowing. Okay, yeah, there's a bunch of water.
I asked to see the
light. You can sort of see some of this out in the distance. This is just where the sea's starting to get deep.
I asked to see the fucking beads.
Okay.
Can I roll
over,
the bead reading?
Hand over the beads.
You hand over the beads. Give it a read, Ollie.
That's legit.
You spend about half an hour looking at it and then realize you've been reading it.
I realize the sun's in my fucking eyes. Can't
you,
read.
You've been reading it from the wrong side, and some of it was maybe caramel. So, yeah, you think you're in the right spot. You're gonna send in the kid.
Yeah,
I'm ready. I'm ready.
He's the one that's meant to be. Can you fucking swim?
What? No. Yeah, of course I can swim.
Okay. Okay. Hold on. So what are you doing here? You've been instructed to check out some shit on the bottom.
I think that was happening when he was thrusting.
No. Okay, so you've been instructed to check out some shit on the bottom of the sea here, on the location given. You've not really been told what.
Okay.
Oh, that's true. So
because there was a cunt that had seen something down there, but he was sort of half blind and couldn't swim, so he couldn't really have a look at it. But he sort of...
Yeah, he's not as awesome as me.
No, he sailed over and went, oh, that looks all right, and then decided to go and... what you can do with the Salvagers Guild or whatever the fuck, you can go and you go, here's a tip for a place I saw something. And then if they go there and there's something, you get a cut. And if they go there and there's nothing, your legs come off. So that's sort of what's happened here. They're not quite sure what's there. And they're sort of... They didn't really think of anything.
Harsh.
No, because, well, well, maybe not legs come off, but they're not happy.
Yes, that's
he saw something dark and big down there, and he figured... And that's really weird, because that's usually not how things look. Usually there's crap floating around. So the guild didn't really care much for it, but they figured it would probably be a safe punishment for Fricko.
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah.
Send them out to the middle of fucking nowhere. What's the worst that could happen? Everything.
Well, they're hoping that the worst does happen by the sounds of it.
Well...
They put me in a boat with you two fuckers. I'm
probably will it matter, this. Though? Are you in the right spot at all?
Sea-wise, do I know where we are and how deep the water is, whether I'm likely to be able to swim down to the bottom?
Roll that shit. Obs 1.
Up in okay. Here.
I'll roll that shit as
come
well.
Come on.
Oh. There, you got it. Never mind.
Yeah, you're fairly familiar with this place. You've actually dived not far from here. And you were a little closer to shore, but that was 2 years ago, and you feel you have improved since. So you should probably be able to make it down there at least.
Right, okay.
Making
my cups in the story. I'm going in, chaps.
Mark your mark your
pull on some aviator goggles.
Remember to mark your shit.
That was a
yes.
Routine, yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at the chart. It was a what?
Routine.
Routine, sorry. Regular.
What's your seamanship at?
1.
Okay, so you need one more difficult to get to seamanship to 2.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But, yeah, it needs to matter to the story. If you can't just beg for cooking skills, you have to...
Have a reason to do it.
Yeah, you have to have a reason. You have to be maybe half being trying to pretend to be a chef at a fancy ball. Then there's a reason. If you just cook Haggard's old slop or something for the king, then probably
you make goulash in someone's house randomly.
That was really dumb.
That was funny.
I thought that was hilariously funny. But...
I panicked a little bit there. Never mind.
Yes. Sorry,
okay.
I didn't mean to derail it there.
How dare you?
I'm a going in there.
Okay, you look down there and you figure it's pretty dark, but you should be able to. You strip down to your loincloth. So you look like that kid in the ad.
Oh, yes.
Okay, you're going to do a thingy test here. You're going to have to meet an Obs 2. Start by rolling swimming.
We're going swimming 1, I think.
Well, you have 1 in swimming.
Yeah.
How?
Because I only got the skills, Captain.
Wait, what's your speed?
Is this where this bug comes in? It's speed 4.
Yeah, then it's 2.
Oh.
It unlocks
the Charburner lies.
Yeah, it's
yeah, it's that. Yeah. Okay, well, I'll have to check with you.
No, if your speed... You don't have to. If your speed is 2, then the skill unlocks at 2.
Right.
Your speed is 4, then the skill unlocks at 2. To the viewers out there, skills in this unlock depending on your physical characteristics. So if you are someone who likes to do
fucking
a lot of
good
squats,
job, son.
If you have an arm wrestling skill, for example, it goes off your power. So if you're a greedy little fuck, you'll have to practice a lot to get arm wrestle skill because you're not physically inclined for it. But if you're a burly man, you start off better naturally. Yeah. Okay, you succeed.
So my holding breath with Fort 5 would unlock at 2 as well.
Yes. Skills round down.
Yes. Okay, and you need to do an Obs 2, so you actually get an extra dice here in the next one from this one, because you're swimming quickly.
Oh, okay.
You met your obstacle here, so this carries right over to the next one. Remember to mark the thing.
Fuck. God damn.
Difficult, if I remember right.
Yeah, I'll...
Yeah, I was going to say.
Remember, it's not your skill, it's how many dice you roll that determines the dice, the obstacle, or the whatever it is. So if you've got 5,000 people helping you crowd surf, you're not actually flying.
Yes.
Whilst he's down there, I'm going to sit back with alcohol.
Swimming. Sorry, talking to myself.
I'm just going to look awkwardly over.
While you're doing that, Ollie, roll fort. Hobbs, too.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm rolling fort, am I?
No, that's Ollie. Hobbs, too.
Okay.
Who, me?
Yes.
Fort, Hobbs, 2. Where the fuck's my fort? Fort is there. Okay. What the fuck? What the fuck happened there?
Somebody messed with that.
God damn it.
It's floating.
What's going on? Get back,
right. There we go.
Okay, but that was a success. Okay, you do not get drunk, but you get the skill check. That is Orbs 2 with 4. That's routine, so that gives you nothing because it's a stat. Alright. Alright, you're diving? You're using your other skills?
I'm using my what skill, sorry?
Your holding breath skill now, plus one.
Yeah. So 2 plus 1.
Yes. This is an Orbs 2. This is the one you needed to make.
Oh, no! Pants.
Oh. Let's see. well, shit. Okay, note down the check, at least.
Okay.
Bear in mind, this is one scene. So until something drastically happens, you can't note any more down on the ones you already noted down on.
So you get one check per scene.
Yeah, per scene. And so like the docks was a scene, but you didn't really do much there. So, and then this is a scene where you're trying to get there and dive, and then there'll be a scene whenever something else happens. Okay, you get halfway down there, and you don't get anywhere near the seabed, but you get near enough to see, and there's just nothing there. It's just bare. There's a crab.
Ooh,
there's two crabs, actually.
Oh, nice. Are they doing anything?
Roll perception.
Roll to see if they're mating.
Awesome. Yes. What is my perception? It's 3, so that's...
Yeah, it's an Orbs 2. They're crabs. They're doing crab shit.
Crab shit.
Walking silent, sideways, and doing the little beep 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 with the hand.
I just note that I love crabs. And very cute.
Right, you burst up through the water again, throwing your hair back in that spiral there, where the water spirals and the Lion King theme plays. And what do you announce to the men?
Saw some crabs, and that was about it.
Oh, wait, hold on. It was an Orbs 2 versus 3. So that's Orbs 2 versus 3. That's actually a difficult on your perception.
So what happens with perception, then?
Well, you get a pip. Look at this thing. Down here it says what you are required to do with stats. Stats are notoriously difficult to level because they don't do anything with routine.
So Dunsten squinted at some crabs and got experience.
Yes, but
nice.
The thing about perception is, if you don't see something...
You don't get shit?
You don't get shit.
Yeah.
The other ones, you get... you get pips for trying, at least. Okay, what do you announce to the men?
Yeah, I saw some crabs, not much else. Get back in the boat. And maybe get prepared for another dive?
I reconsult the beads. Gotta go. I'm pretty sure I got this right the first time.
Are you in agreement that crabs was not what you were looking for?
I'm pretty sure they wouldn't have sent me out for something quite so fucking banal.
They were
extremely cute crabs, though.
They're so kawaii.
With their pincers, and they were walking sideways. I love it when they walk sideways.
Yeah,
they always walk sideways.
It's a specific type of crab as well, where the pincers go like this.
Are you doing the action with your hands, and we can't see you?
I'm drawing.
No, he's drawing it.
They go like this.
Sorry, I've got the...
Like that. And it looks like a little heart.
Oh, you see?
Fucking crabs, and they're like red and white in these really bright clownfish type colours. Okay, never mind that. yeah, you know it was supposed to be darkish down there. That's what the dudes said, and sort of jagged. Not coral. Usually that likes... It likes up here. This is coral.
Mm.
It likes being in the shallows because it needs light. This was just sort of dark.
There is deep sea coral, though. I'm not sure what that's like.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
But
only because I watch Octonauts, you see. So.
Oh, I see. I'm assuming you guys don't know that either, since you don't have fucking what's his face Ridley Scott's diving thing. Or is that James Camp?
I have no idea.
Who's the cunt that constantly hangs out at the Titanic?
Oh.
No idea. Right, so
Kevin Costner. Yeah, something.
Something like
that. Has Senior Fricko read the beads yet, then?
Sure.
Give it another crack?
Yeah, sure. Normally, there's these rules called Let It Ride, where if you read it wrong, you read it wrong, but...
In this case, though, I'm not finding anything, am I?
Yeah, so I'm thinking this is sufficient cause for me to go, all right, I might have fucked up.
Yeah. Yeah,
ah,
sort of
shit, I fucked up.
You sort of... There's a little brown bead there, and you pick at it a little bit, and some shit comes off, and it's actually red. So, it was left instead of right somewhere, and it was, 400 strokes with the oar rather than 50.
Oh, fuck.
Although, bear in mind, this is proper man strokes. This is what Ollie does, not Fricko. Mm.
I've caused problems twice.
See?
Okay, so,
puny arms and my shitty bead reading.
Since you've already read the beads, you don't get a tick.
That's what I was thinking. Don't get a tick for that.
But what you can do is, if you do a difficult and succeed that, you can replace it with a routine or something like that. If you did something meaningless earlier and you pull off some heroic effort, then you can I would rather have that instead of that one. It has
so
to be in the same.
So I can get rid of the routine and mark it as the difficult I just did.
Yes. If that's
fair enough. That makes sense.
Okay.
I grumble. Ask where we're going then.
I kind of look at the beads. Relay instructions.
Okay. Seamanship, Ollie.
Seamanship. Seamanship.
Yeah. Did you get Dunsten back in the boat?
Oh wait, what fucking hell? Okay, that works, sure.
Okay.
I got back in the boat straight away.
Okay, you get out here-ish. This is sort of roll your sea wise or whatever the fuck you had, Dunsten?
I got sea wise. Always Dunsten doing it.
You can both.
I have one in sea wise. Actually, I wonder if that should be higher. I don't know.
Actually, that's the point. Do I get a routine in my seamanship for that?
No, you already did seamanship. It's still the same scene.
Oh, yeah.
No,
I did sea wise before. Oh, forget it, don't matter.
Did you sea wise? Okay, yeah, then you get in seamanship. The seamanship is what you use to navigate, so I'm assuming
okay,
that's
so
what
that
you
ops?
Used.
Two, or?
Yeah, two, sure.
So, difficult, fucking hell, yes.
Yeah, that's alright. Okay, What's your... Sawbones has put on blindfolds and can't see anything. Is he gone done in again? Yep. For fuck's sake. Okay, I'm gonna explain some shit meanwhile. What did you say your thingy skill was, Jeeves?
One. Sea-wise is one. But I'm wondering if it should be higher.
Yeah, what's your perception?
Perception.
All wise is... Yeah, then it's one.
Oh, good. Right.
Yeah.
I should really work out what the mechanic for that is, but... Oh.
It's just half the stat.
Oh, okay. Rounded down.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Roll that shit. Roll it. Obs 2. Roll it. Mm-hmm. Nice. We wait for the man. Yeah, well, you don't really... You think it looks kind of deep. And as you sort of set out here, you're thinking, I can't make the fucking bottom here. I can't even get near it because it's just getting deeper and deeper.
Hmm. So I announce this. We're too deep. This doesn't look right.
Yeah. Keep trying to call man in who has now for the third time fallen out the call.
Ah, fucking Skype.
Yes, you put that on my fucking... audition things. Don't disconnect every 5 seconds. No impotent
connection.
Hopefully
got my problem with that sorted.
Yeah.
We could try different software, like GoToMeeting or some other shit.
Fuck that.
Is that even worse?
I think so. I don't know.
Probably.
I'm comfortable with Skype. It doesn't do anything for me.
Sawbones isn't.
Not usless. Keep trying to call him. That's probably doing a lot worse. He's gonna flip this fucking thing.
There we fucking go.
Oh, there
so
you
sorry
are.
About
okay.
That.
Well, third time's the sorriest.
Okay, through everything.
You're sort of heading out here, and everyone's Jeeves has announced it's probably too deep. Ollie, were you going to roll C-wise?
I already did some.
Okay, that's your C-wise?
Yeah.
And Ollie goes, yeah, but I think there might be some reef and shit a little further out.
Oh, so we want to go a little bit further then?
Yeah, possibly. That's up to you.
Okay. Well, sounds good, yeah. That's quite possible that it's going to get shallower, so...
If that's what you want, let's do it.
Right, your sail. You are here now.
Rowing.
It's about... not entirely the end of the day. One of the fucking tenants of that fucking church is always... There's two that I've decided on. Always give corpses to the ferryman and pay the ferryman. And... no working or being out at night. That doesn't mean you have to get back, it just means that there's a little tent type thing you can flop over the canoe and have a nap in that. But no dicking around, it's like the fucking Sabbath. No cunting.
No collecting sticks.
What's the current light situation?
It's sort of slightly... there's sort of a ring around the sun which indicates that it's getting into late afternoon. So you're above the thing now, or at least what you think is the thing. It's dark down there. It was true. This is probably where the man mentioned.
Well, I can go down and have a look.
Yeah.
See if you can find a lobster.
Oh yeah, lobsters aren't as good as crabs.
Crustacean wise.
Crustacean.
Okay, same thing again. Swimming and then breath holding. Obs too. If you do the first one, you'll get an extra on the second one.
Cool.
If you fuck it up, it'll be an extra obstacle on the second one. Yep, unless you want to explode that. This is a new scene, by the way, since you're in a new spot. So, mark that.
Nice. What was that, a difficult?
Two versus two? That would be a difficult, yes.
Right. Got to learn to look on that chart for myself. Right.
Oi. I didn't do that at all when we were doing it with Luke. I didn't understand any of that. What's that? And every fucking time he had to tell me. What a babby. He might as well just have breastfed me.
Yeah, I feel the same though. It's like, what? What? What's going on?
Yeah. I can't keep all this in my head though, so for the story to progress anywhere, you guys are going to have to start homeboying. That's why it's good this is a video. Then when one of you inevitably die and a new man comes in...
you can just go, watch the fucking video and
find
out.
The video, for fuck's sake, not saying this again. Okay, yeah. So yeah, right. you fucked that up. That means the next one is obs free.
Unless I explode that six.
Yeah.
For one fate.
Are you exploding the six? I wouldn't, honestly.
How often do you get fate points?
Depends on how many times you use your beliefs and your instincts. Beliefs and instincts form faith and persona. If you don't use your belief or instincts at all, ever, you don't get fate and persona.
Right. Okay, I guess I won't do that. About my beliefs, though, I am doing, something that is a belief of mine, you know, marine salvage. That's what I want to do. That's what I enjoy. So I don't know. Is that
that's right.
It's something that gets totted up at the end, right?
Yeah, that's your job, I guess. So I mean, that's something you'd be doing. It's,
yeah,
it's kind of like being a guy and having a belief. I want a cock, but just you have one. So
well, yeah, a bit new. But before you told me that. Really, marine salvage is quite difficult to get into, and not many people do it. And most people are just fishing cunts.
Maybe we should say that if he's successful, then it counts. He can't just be salvaging, but if he salvages successfully,
right,
then he gets rewarded for it. Okay.
That's good.
Maybe
okay.
just change that a little bit then. Because you can't just have something that farms like that where there's no real input from you. It's like...
Yeah, I didn't think that it would be farming like that. I thought it would be harder to get into than just, oh, here, have a job, and go and do it.
Oh, well, I mean, this is sort of a half intro, both to the setting and everything, and also because I have asked preparing for this, so... okay, so you're diving.
Okay.
Obs 3 versus 3.
So 3 dice?
3 dice versus... No, wait, actually, no, it's 2 dice. 2 dice, obs 2. Sorry. Well, you get sort of some of the way down there again, and you see this thing, this big reef. Pixel paint, fuck off. I want a vector paint. There we go. This big reef type thing. And on the side of it here, there's this weird thing you haven't really seen. It's big and dark. It's got these little... like that. These.
So while I failed, I kind of only failed about as bad as that guy did.
What guy?
The guy who sent us out here, gave us the tip. He just saw something big and dark down here.
Ah, piss. he sort of... There we go. He sort of saw it from above, so he just saw something dark. You sort of got the shape of it. So you plop back up and sort of... Ow! Ah! Oh, man. Oh, I just pinched my fucking arm against the table with the chair. Oh, a little bit of flesh just completely crushed. I'm fine. Yeah, you sort of see that. It's like, I'm sort of drawing it to keep it vague.
Yeah.
This bit was very dark. This looked wooden.
Well, since we're in water world, I'm just going to assume that it's a ship. Or a boat.
Good man.
Or a plug.
A plug? It was balanced pretty precariously on this, and there was a long way down there.
How big is this? It looks really huge.
It's fairly fucking big. I mean, this was you.
Nice.
Jesus.
Yeah. Well, those torturer guys are going to be so annoyed when we come back with the mother load.
Well, there's no way you're gonna get this fucking thing home, but...
Well, no.
It looked sort of... There were cracks here in this, but... This looked sort of milky. Which is his way of not recognizing glass.
Ah.
It's an ironclad.
So is there anything
right.
you can do with
well, I'll go... sorry.
No, I'm just asking Rufus, is there anything that we can do with what we know now?
Well, you can go back and just say, there's a thing there, go get it. Or you can try and get some stuff. Or it's up to you. Normally in these sort of operations, you get paid better if you get something with your home. These scouting ones are less lucrative because it'll just be the first crew out there. To get the shit, they'll get the most pay. But it depends on what you want to do. You have a bunch of rope. I mean, Dunsten usually does a thing where he swims down, ties up some crap, and then it's pulled up. But you have a rather small boat, so that's kind of difficult. So if you'd need anything, it would be smaller. Maybe if you gave some way for Dunsten to either get down faster or have more air as he goes down. There would be a way for you to actually have a better look at what it is, because with the info you have right now, there's not much to do.
I'm assuming we don't have any technology like that in this world.
Do we have any rope on us?
Yes, you have rope.
Do we have anything weighty on us at all?
There's a pot.
I have a grappling iron kind of thing that I used to.
There's something something that we don't specifically need that we can throw off? You said we have a pot, right?
Most boats have a metal plate in the middle, sort of a thin metal plate that they use to that holds the fire when you burn something, which is usually like some sort of peat, kelp type thing. Not kelp, but some sort of weed. Mm. You also know that when it gets dark, the water gets lower. There's this like tide. Which is weird because that doesn't happen around the islands. It's only further away.
There's no tide at the islands, only...
No.
So
it doesn't really make much sense.
No.
No.
This so makes the island from Lost look perfectly...
It's almost as if stuff's coming up from below rather than the water sinking.
Oh. What, the whole island moves up and down with the tide?
That's possible.
Yeah, it might be that. Well,
you should have made Grease Muzzle. He'd have figured that shit out.
Yeah. He couldn't dive, though.
He's a scholar. Or die, maybe. The V part, yeah. Not so much.
I was gonna recommend that we tie some shit to Dunsten, weigh him down so he goes deeper. Then when he wants to come back up, he just unties himself.
You mean like a professional freediver? Or not freediver, where they just sent down with that little ball?
Yep.
We could get something off the ship and then use that, couldn't we?
But how pissed off is the relative going to be for us taking apart his fucking vessel?
Well, no, I mean not our boat, the one that's underwater.
True. But we'd have to get down there first.
It's just a free plate that's in the middle.
Yeah, we tie a rope around the weight, he holds onto it, drop to the bottom, he lets go of the plate, we pull the plate up. Easy.
Sounds good. Yeah, actually, that's actually a good shout.
You also have an empty water skin from that you drank going there.
We could also use that for extra air.
Mm. Oh, I see.
That would make him harder to sink, though.
Well, if he had both. One hand holding the plate, the other hand holding the skin.
Yeah, so we killed the child. They come back. What happened? A terrible crustacean incident. There's nothing we can do.
He came down with a terminal case of crabs.
What's the diver's suggestion? He's the pro here.
Yeah, he knows better than us.
I could go down with the plate and the thing, the water skin, and get some more weight off the boat, and then use that.
No one's considering waiting until night.
Well, you said we're not allowed to wait.
Until night?
I'm not going to break the law.
Well, you can... I said there was a law. I didn't say you weren't allowed.
Oh, it just seems strange to break the law on purpose for no reason.
I vote that we try first. If it doesn't work, then we wait till night.
I'm not comfortable with this, but it's coming from you, so... Yeah, okay.
Is the tide coming in or out?
Well, it's not really tied.
Is it? Is the water here getting deeper, or is it getting shallower?
It's getting shallower. The thing is coming closer to the surface.
Right.
At night.
Yes.
We've had ourselves
any drops.
A breakdown.
Okay. I was diving down to blue.
I've lost my marbles.
No, you. They're perfectly balanced.
Oh.
So I'll go back up. I suppose I'm out of air and I have to go back up to the surface. For now.
Yeah, yeah. You've just breached the surface and you've had a conversation.
Yeah.
That's good. So yeah, it looks like the water. So it looks like it's getting shallower. So let's wait until.
You've also never seen anything like this before.
Yes.
And you have never dived at night, so you're not really sure what to expect.
Right, okay. But it seems like a sensible idea and we agree to dive at night because it's shallower. And this is the mother load. It looks like something really amazing down there.
Yes. Well, an ironclad is sort of probably the biggest source of iron that, well, if you don't know it's an ironclad character-wise, but it is. And it's probably going to be the biggest source of iron that's ever fucking been there. But it's also very precariously balanced and you're not sure if it falls into the abyss. It's gone.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, personally, I don't think fucking with this is a particularly good idea. We came here, we found it, we go back. It's in someone else's responsibility.
I'm all for the salvaging.
But if we leave it, then we don't earn as much.
Mm,
but no, I'm keeping the fuck out of this. This will end up in a battle of wits.
oh, duel of wits. No, actually, I made mistakes last time we did that.
Yeah, there wasn't, but you didn't factor in beginner's luck, did you?
Yeah.
No. But it's getting sort of dark, slowly, so you'll have to either make an attempt now within the next hour.
I will go for that then.
Or have the spend the night here and then do something tomorrow.
I want to make my case that we just give it a try right now with the tools we have to hand. If we can't do it, we fucking go home.
I agree with that, Junction. And as captain, my word is law, fuck you all.
It's true. Okay, so what are you doing to the poor child?
giving him a metal plate and a bag full of air and throwing him into the water.
We're making him drown.
You put a rope to the poor boy.
Skill.
Yeah, if you have him get a rope down there and secure it somehow, he can drag himself down faster next time, and also up.
That's true.
The swimming skill would not have to.
But will it take more time to do that, making several trips?
The adults are debating what to do with a child. This is like being a fucking intern at a industrial cleaning company. Feels like that, or like send the intern in. I don't want to go in the silo
to clean up the spill. Yeah.
Charles been sick, get your turn in.
Killed.
Yeah, I really want to salvage as much as possible.
Good boy.
Okay, so, give him the fucking rope.
Doing, man.
Okay.
Give him the rope.
That'll plop him in there. Okay,
Oh, have a heavy plate then. Backing up. Wait, are we giving
do
him the
plate?
Do we
need to do anything like knots or...
I was about to say, do we want to like...
Rash the rope to the plate.
Okay.
So we can haul it back up afterwards. Aye.
Yeah, metal's very expensive. The plates, they're probably the most expensive part of the boat.
That's why I wanted to make sure that...
We better not
good.
Fucking lose.
Yeah. Let's wait with the rope.
Oh.
Actually, no, let's do the rope. It's obs one.
The obs?
Obs one. Do you have better rope than him?
Fuck.
Dunsty.
Do I have better rope?
Yeah. One.
I don't think so.
Okay, you just made it.
It's just in my skill toolkit, I thought.
Obs 1, so that'd be a routine.
Yeah. Oh, very fine.
Very fine.
Okay, so... The rope looks good. So, do you send him down with the rope, or do you send the rope down ahead of him, or what happens? Could have had him pick a
rope
up.
I'll go down with the plate, wouldn't I?
Yeah, okay. Hold breath roll.
And I'm using the water container thing, whatever it was.
Oh yeah, bottle of air.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's an extra dice, yeah. Okay. Obs 2.
There's one.
There's two.
Hey.
Right, you make it down. You touch the fucking thing. You have about 2 minutes.
While we're waiting, I just kind of look over at Ollie's character and go,
thank you.
So,
I've done a
can
holding.
I have a little bit of that?
There are little bits of...
You want the fucking drink?
Well,
so
we've
I
been
don't
out here for hours.
I don't have a mark, do I? Because,
you know what?
Sorry, I have to ask a stupid question. That was a routine check, right?
Yes.
But I don't make another mark because I've already held my breath once before.
This scene, yes, you don't make a mark.
Right.
Okay, all around the rim of this thing, there are these little sort of handles out.
I guess you could probably tie one onto that. Meanwhile, up on the boat, I give my fucking alcohol to Fricko.
All right, both of you roll fort, obs 2.
Nice.
Notice that this is an obs 2, so there'll never really be any chance of... Oh. There'd never be any chance of you getting any skill from it other than getting drunk.
Yeah, I'm good.
You're alright.
We're fucking fine.
Okay.
Getting
at the
old
age of 18,
on.
I can handle my drink.
So, Dunsty, what's the plan, yo?
So assuming that I took my rope down with me, I'd like to tie my rope off against one of those.
Up again. Okay, so there's a rope here. Weet.
Okay, and I'll give the other one... Can I give it a little tug? So, actually, let's not do that.
They'll try and pull it up.
Yeah, we yank back.
Yeah, drunkenly.
What are you doing with the metal plate? It was tied to the end of the rope.
It is going to stay there because it's the most expensive part of the ship, and my cousin will not be happy if you value your legs. We will save them.
All right, you've just taken the last gulp of air in the thing. You have about a minute and a half.
Right, I look for an entry. And we're in.
Well, there's here. Where the window is cracked.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll can I open that? Like, is it... I know it's a porthole, but what does Dunsten know? Can he see a way to open that? Or?
Do a speed check. Obs 2.
Speed of 4, I'm rolling 4 dice, and...
Yes, okay, that's fine. You realize the glass is sharp, but you didn't cut yourself. You might easily have done. You've never seen glass before, so it surprised you a little bit that the weird see-through thing, which mostly you'd know from fucking jellyfish, was actually hard and sharp. But you think you can probably squeeze through it if you wanted to. It's very dark in there, though.
Yeah, okay, I'll try and squeeze through there.
You squeeze through. You go up a little bit, and in the sort of... Right here, there's a pocket of air. Will you try to breathe this air?
Oh, is this a really bad idea? So swimming-wise, would I know if that's a really bad idea to breathe stale air?
Have you had any experience with it before?
I don't think so. Unless he swam into a cave underwater or something and came up.
That could have happened, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure, do a swimming-wise.
Alright, so that's 2.
Okay, what you're rolling here for is this is being safe.
Yeah.
I haven't decided yet, so 1 and it's safe. Yeah, you should be good.
Okay, I go into the pocket.
Remember to mark your thing.
Yeah. Shite.
It smells like old ass.
That's probably why I said shite.
Old ass.
Yeah.
Wait, how can you smell what it is if it's underwater?
He's got into an
air pocket.
He's in an air pocket.
Ah, fair enough.
You sort of, you're clanging your feet against some shit that's loose below you, but the thing creaks a little bit. The air pocket's pretty big, though. You think you could probably subside on that for a good hour. Less if there were more people down there with you, hint hint. But,
Right. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I could get the other homos down and we could go around the...
You could ask. You have a very small boat, though, so it can take a lot of weight, and iron is a lot of weight.
Aye, luckily we have a floating house on water that
no, we don't know
might
yet.
Be able to carry more.
If I come
also
back,
quite shit. What you need is a proper boat with a wooden frame. Any bone boat will be bent out of shape and just rip.
Oh, I see.
So you need one of the big salvage ships, one of the good ones.
So Ollie's ship wouldn't do?
No,
Ollie's ship is too shit. It needs to be one of the big men boats.
Like, we could get handfuls, I'd assume. Like,
if there were smaller bits, you could get some.
Yeah. I'm kind of interested to look for little artifacts and strange things
that
we might find.
Do perception.
Okay.
Actually, no, do your hold breathing and perception. And hold breathing, yeah.
Oh, hold breath, okay. So I'll do hold breath first and then perception.
Yeah.
Is that the idea? Right.
Orbs 1. Yeah, you make that one, so you get an extra to your perception. Because you can search for longer, and it's obs 3. Actually, no, it's obs 2.
And this is a perception roll.
Yeah.
Oh, and I get an extra one. So I've got perception 3, add 1, right.
4.
If you don't want the extra, if you don't want the extra...
fucking
that'll do.
Say so if you don't want the extra, because that means you can't level it.
Right, yes, because that's no longer a difficult action.
Quickly, remove one.
Yes, well, alright. Too late.
Yeah, you get a good feel around there. There seems to be doors leading into the other place, and there seems to be more air pockets. You sort of feel some small ones with your hands every now and then as you go down, but it seems like there's a lot of stuff resting against walls, like bulkheads and crap like that, that's trying to sort of fall down into the arse of this. Like you get some small bits and bobs. You're not really sure what the fuck they are, but you get an armful of shit.
Good.
And you're back in the place again.
Air pocket. Okay, so I will make my way outside and trailing the rope behind me that's tied onto the handholds.
Yeah.
I'll homo my way up the rope.
Shouldn't you be also tugging on the fucking rope to pull, let us pull you up?
Yeah, you could do it that way.
Well, that's what he meant by homoing.
Oh,
really,
okay,
fuck's
homoing.
Sake.
Okay, sorry. Yeah.
homoing so we can...
Fuck's sake, use your verbs properly, damn it. Okay, so...
Homo is not a verb, I understand.
Oh. You do not live in Brighton.
No, I live in fucking Spania, son.
What the fuck did I just do? Oh, there we go, okay. Yeah, you come up and you sort of load all your shit into the place. Into the boat, and everyone's looking at it sort of like, oh.
I look at the knickknacks that he's brought up.
It's about a meter of old chain. Not very rusted.
Huh.
And a bunch of shit. There's a little box, metal, locked, it looks like. Oh, well, it's not openable. There seems to be. You don't have concepts of locks, but there's a keyhole in it. So that doesn't mean anything to you.
It's a square metal block with a hole.
Yeah, it's a weird square fucking thing.
Can I shake it?
You can shake it.
See?
But you don't really hear much because it's full of water.
Yeah.
So there's just whatever's in there sloshes a little bit. And it's slowly draining water, but very, very slowly.
Mm.
And there is what looks like a... it's like a one of the cords from one of those old telephones.
So,
like one of those things you hold up to your ear.
Yeah.
From like
receiver part, you mean?
Yeah.
The little cup part we put against your ear. Yeah. Fair enough.
Of course.
But there was a lot more shit down there. You just took the things that felt the smoothest or the weightiest that you figured you could get up there. But there's a lot more crap.
Huh. So I described to the others the precarious nature of the ship.
How excited are you?
Sorry?
How excited are you? You are a child after all.
Yeah, I'm on scale of 1 to jizzing in my pants, probably about an 8 or a 9.
Nice. Okay, so yeah, because you've never seen anything like this before. And
that's like full hard on, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah, little bit of pre-cum.
Pokes a little hole in the bottom of the boat with his massive cock.
Yeah,
oh god, what? Right.
Aww. At least we're not ripping Smurfs.
You all sink and die. I'll be looking for 3 more people for next week. Okay. Yeah, and you got that stuff, and it's slowly starting to get slightly dark.
Mm.
You should probably hunker down soon. But what's the plan,
men?
We
pulled the metal plate up so that we can make a...
Yeah.
And I've described the air pockets as well and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So I turn to the men. Do we all go down there following the rope? Because that would require none of us to really swim, just hold our breaths. Or would we hot hand in what we've got?
Do seaman's wise. Seaman wise.
Yeah.
Seaman.
Always wise about seaman.
Yeah. You think it would probably be best to have someone in the boat, just to give it a little weight.
I volunteer to stay in the boat.
Okay, then.
Because I have the lung capacity of a swallow.
Do you trust this man to stay in the boat, not cut the rope and leave, and then give the location and come back to your corpses?
That's a good point, actually. We've only just met the...
What? Okay. I don't want to do anything like that. Twice.
Mine's okay, reminded so... of a fucking certain strap-on.
What?
What?
It was a golden cod piece, now it's a strap-on. No, wait, you don't have that. Oh.
It was as if another adventure or something, or a dream.
Yeah, past life and shit.
A parallel dimension.
Anyway.
So, yes. All right then. So, what's the... Frico, you understand that we're above the mother load, and you're not very good at giving coordinates, right? So if you rope and fucked off, then...
I make the point.
Bear in mind, no one has said anything about the rope. You're just saying this to him. No one's mentioned anything about actually doing that. That was an aside, so you're just saying this to him.
I just like
this. Right off the bat. Right.
I say it completely out of context. Like, my mind's racing ahead to what we're going to do next. And I just say, look, yeah, asshole.
Like, Frico is genuinely looking quite hurt.
Hurt and greasy. He glistens.
Yes, you're quite greasy right now. It's making me upset. So,
whenever I go to the water, I just leave an oil slick across the surface of it.
Thinking is, we homo down on the rope, and you know. Oh no, because you already volunteered.
Nautical terms.
I'm just.
You already. It's a legit nautical term in this water world.
I'm
without Kevin Costner.
Waiting for people to pay attention. Bear in mind, he can't row for shit. He's got the physical aptitude of a wet noodle.
He already so he does know noodle. What's going on because he volunteered to stay on the boat, right?
Think of it this way, like, if he did try anything stupid, we'd probably be able to catch up with him. Like, we'd probably be able to swim than this little, like, weedy baby man could row.
Yeah.
While this conversation is going on, it's getting dark. You'll have to camp here.
I'm just going to assemble the roof, and you guys can do the diving. I'm okay with that.
Should we do another dive tonight, or shall we wait until the morning?
You know what? I don't honestly fucking care. Unless he just starts assembling the
much?
sulking torturer.
Both a bunch of shits.
Whilst Mr. Torturer is assembling shit, can I check how much light we probably have left?
Going to bed. Sorry, what?
I'm sorry.
How much light do we have left? Like, how much?
Not much. The slit is slowly forming up there.
Okay.
You've got about half an hour, maybe an hour.
So we've got half hour till dark sun. Okay. Okay, I vote we have a quick dash down there, see what we can grab, and then leave it at that.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Great.
Meanwhile, man is napping, sulking.
And before I go, I say I'm sorry for calling you greasy.
He didn't mean it.
Yeah, I didn't mean it though. You are a bit, but anyway,
it's very greasy.
Just glares at you as you go.
Okay. There's no problem for Dunsten getting back down there. He secured a rope again, so Ollie will just need to make the.
I just happily give him my booze bottle before I leave. Something nice to remember.
All right. So you go down there.
Mm-hmm.
Dunsty is down here already.
Okay.
He's, that was hold breathy. You don't have that, do you?
No. So beginner's luck, I'd assume.
Yes, beginner's luck. It is off fort.
Fort.
And it's an obs 2 getting down there, so it's an obs 4.
Obs 4?
Yeah, it doubles when it's beginner's luck.
Thankfully, my fort is 4, so... No, fuck.
Okay, you get about 2/3 down, and then you start looking weird. Dunsten sees this.
Does Dunsten have the...
Will you part with the precious air in your lungs? In a manly kiss.
Oh, I give him a kiss of life kind of thing underwater. That's alright, yeah, I'll do that.
Okay.
On the surface, I'm just laying there going, why do they keep using homo as a verb for everything? As they're macking underwater.
We are homoing, yes.
Okay, well, I guess it would have been apt here, but anyway. Okay, you get down, you get to the thing here, and you notice it's not big enough for Ollie, as it is. You'll have to smash some of the glass.
Okay, I have my knife, right? I can use even my grapple.
You slam it a bit with the knife, and it sort of comes off. But Ollie is very, very running out of air at this point.
So
he'll have to make a mad scramble with speed to get in there. It's an obs 2, Ollie.
Okay.
Wait, what's your speed?
4.
Okay, have an ops 3.
I mean, motherfucker.
No.
That's alright.
You want a level, play. Don't you?
Ah, oh, shit. Mm-hmm.
See, if it had been 2, I would have made it.
Okay, you get a superficial wound.
Okay.
Going through there.
Oh, yes.
And so you get up, you scratch yourself a little bit. because it was 3 versus 4 here, Ollie, you get a difficult on your speed.
Ah, mucho tibium.
And indeed.
I did have a thought. So our boat is tied to this enormous iron one, and the iron one is very precariously balanced. So
yes,
just make the suggestion to Ollie that don't knock it off. Don't touch shit that might fall down and cause the big iron boat to sink, because we'll be
si, senor.
I have 2 microphones to mute when I cough, and I think I just fucked up the stream one. The recording one. Sorry.
Oh, God.
Sorry, man.
Anyway.
Okay.
So I'm in the ship.
Yeah, you're in the ship. You're sitting there with him.
So, perception to look around to see what we can fucking find?
Oh, there's a pile of shit. He's already looked around earlier, so he knows where the crap is.
All right.
Unless you're going further down in the thing. It's getting very dark, by the way.
Yeah, in that case, probably just grab what we can find, grab here, and take it up.
Yeah. Okay, is this what happens?
Yes.
Get up without much trouble. Get an armful of shit. There's some more chain. That seemed like the easiest thing to get up.
By the way, going back a minute, do I put a tick onto heavy breathing or whatever?
Oh yeah, that was beginner's luck, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What's your fort?
Fort is... Where the fuck is my fort? It is 4.
Okay, so your aptitude for that is 6.
Okay.
You've gotten 1 little tick in that. Go on, skills being learned, right, aptitude 6, and deep breath or something. Or hog lungs, or whatever the fuck we decided to call it. And then put 1 dot in there. Once you have reached the number of dots that your aptitude says you have, then you have learned the skill.
Okay.
Okay.
I just called it holding breath, yeah.
Well, yeah, I guess. Okay, you get up, you get a bunch of chains and some piss and some clipboards and some pens and crap that have abandoned old ink.
I was gonna say, do they work?
Various sort of things. There's something that you're not really sure what is. It was the biggest and heaviest thing. I can tell you now it's an old typewriter.
I was going to say you found a fucking torpedo or something.
Suddenly the entire bay goes up.
What is this giant metal donger? Let's go disassemble it. Clank, clank, boom. Shit.
It's like that boat that's in the English Channel, isn't it? That's absolutely full of explosives, full of bombs.
What? Shit.
Yeah, seriously, look it up. There's a boat in the English Channel. It was coming across from the US during the war, absolutely full of blockbuster bombs ready to drop on Germany, and it sank. It hit a sandbar.
What?
And it's still there.
While you're looking this up, look up Floyd's Bank Croppolite while you're at it. It is the biggest recorded shit taken by a Viking in the Thames, I think. Okay.
Oh, sweet mother of Christ.
That was a guy that wanted to show it off in the exhibition, and he dropped it, so it broke. So it's no longer the biggest complete shit. It's just the biggest shit. They tried to fix it, but no. Anyway, you're up there. You had to let the typewriter go, though, because it was just too heavy. The boat was starting to act weird.
Okay.
So you toss it down, and it's very dark now.
Wait, we toss what down, sorry?
You're having to make that decision, the typewriter.
Okay.
Thing.
The big burly thing.
I can hardly hear you now, Jeeves. You've done something.
Oh.
You've fallen. That's fine.
Alright. What were you saying then?
Basin. You hear me alright?
See?
Yeah, a little. Yeah. You're sort of half volume of what you were just a second ago.
That's fucking weird. I wonder if Skype's.
There you go. You just have to keep talking. Skype turns you down if you fart in the microphone or something.
Okay. Oh, it's probably when I was pissing myself laughing. Yeah.
Yeah,
you did show us the world's biggest poo, so what was I supposed to do?
Well, it wasn't the world's biggest. The world's biggest ancient Viking poo.
Why have we discussed...
Yeah. Anyway, never mind that. Okay, yes. So...
I'm going to sleep now.
You got your thing. So you're about to go to sleep then. Right, it's dark.
Right, well, are we going to have a fire first, keep warm, or?
Yeah,
it doesn't really get cold.
Well, I'm assuming we're eating something at the very least.
Yeah, eating something. You worked so hard today.
Yeah. I had a big day today.
This grease doesn't secrete itself.
You don't want to see me without my grease. I got all dry and crispy.
I'd like to point out that Fricko has the trait greasy. This is why we are haranguing him.
And if you have a trait that's something like that, it doesn't just mean he's
fucking greasy.
Yeah.
Exuding the shit.
He could go down a completely dry slip and slide without problem.
Yeah.
Okay, so are you starting going to sleep after eating and shit like that?
I suppose.
Mm. All right.
Yeah. I'll probably keep a watch out for general nighttime activities for a bit.
Alright.
Might have fucking bandits
or
something.
I feel very safe out here, so yeah.
Okay, so who's sleeping, who isn't?
I'm
keeping awake for a bit.
Watch.
Yeah, what? I'll keep watch for a bit.
Okay, there's sort of a low thumping.
Does it sound like it's coming from underwater?
Yes.
Okay, so untie us. Let's untie our boat from the big iron one down below.
What you've done is you've taken the water skin with the... Why am I telling you what you've done? But what one might have done is taken the water skin, filled it with air, tied that to the rope, and just have it float.
Okay.
That makes sense. I was thinking of trying to use some kind of buoy to mark it.
There you go. I took the idea right out of your brain.
Oh, God, my brains.
I'm not forcing my game mastery shit on you, no.
No, you said there's a thumping or something.
Yeah.
From underneath our boat.
It sort of feels like a slow heartbeat.
Oh, shit.
What? How?
You're all sitting there under the tent. I'm not sure which one of you are awake at this point.
I'm still awake. I'm asleep. I wish to look around the water to see if I can
This
see
is generally where nannies and child rearers and cunts like that always go, just sleep, don't look, don't do anything, and that's one of the reasons don't stay awake at night. Normally when this sort of thing, weird shit happens at night as a child, you're just instructed to lay down and sleep. This is in the back of your minds.
Yeah, I am fast fucking asleep.
He's just
okay.
Lying there going, err. But is anyone doing anything that's not that?
No thanks.
Okay, you're not having a look.
Oh shit, it's some plot. Quick, get out of the way.
Fucking hell, I'm committed.
Okay, Ollie's having a look.
I just have a sneaky peek.
There's sort of a dull green glow coming from the windows under the thing. It's closer now. It's risen a little bit. It's a few meters above the water surface. Much closer.
Above the water surface?
No, closer to the water surface. It was like 10 meters down before. Now it's maybe three.
And so there's a light green glow or something?
Yeah, coming from inside this thing.
Can I see?
Do you want to wake us?
Sort of like this.
I slowly nudge the fucking men. Say, men, please.
Okay, yes, I'm ready! And I jump up and
look
ready for
action. Oh, God.
I grab and hold him down and say that there's green shit in the boat that we just stole from.
You can't notice the thumping and see the green shit. Is anyone scared and would like to play an instinct?
Yes,
I could jump in the water. That would be my instinct.
Yeah. Are you gonna do this?
Yeah, fuck it.
Okay, you jump in the water. This is your instinct.
I slowly reach for my weapon because I feel very insecure.
I follow suit with the captain and pull a knife.
Alright, how does Dunsten feel about being in the water?
Pretty fucking good. It's a lot safer. I try to swim around the ship and find out what's going on the other side of it.
Well, the thumping was coming from below the water, and there's sort of the light coming from the what's it called?
Are they coming from two different places?
The thumping just seems to be coming from below the surface. You can't really distinguish where. It feels like just all around.
Really, it's a poor play of his instinct, because the idea is he gets on a fight in dry land.
Yeah, I know. And, I mean, we can reverse it. I mean, if you would like.
Nah, it's all right. It's done.
Okay.
He's committed.
How does he feel about being in the water with all this shit?
Does his sphincter is gyrating.
God.
And
undulating sphincter. I see.
Undulating, yeah. And I'm wondering how what does the thumping sound like in his ears? Because, you know, it's in the water, right?
It feels like if you're at a disco and there's just a bass.
That fast?
No, it's a slow heartbeat, but it feels like sort of it punches you slightly in the diaphragm rather than feel like a sound.
Does it punch harder if I swim closer to the ship? Or?
Not that much. It seems to be coming from very far below.
Oh.
Wow. In the abyss.
That's interesting.
Hmm.
Can I swim? Well, I mean, I'm shitting myself, but...
Well, when you're looking up, the sort of moon is glaring at you through the water.
It's looking at me.
Well, it does that. It looks at
my fucking spear for dear life. I turn to friggin' Fricko. It's like, can we run out of here? I'm not really comfortable in this situation.
Yes, and right now, yes.
Fuck the rules. I'm captain. I'm scared shitless.
You make the rules. You are the fucking captain.
Exactly.
Well, the eye is normal to you guys. It's not generally something that people are happy being out at. Generally, you have to sort of limit your exposure to it.
Well,
that's what you're taught anyway. You have no idea why.
With the nighttime eye.
Yeah.
The dark sun.
So we know it's an eye then, do we?
The dark sun.
It's dark sun.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, you don't know it's an eye, or if it even is an eye, or, well, it looks like one, but not the sort of eye you've ever seen. Fish have weird eyes.
That's true. But
okay, what are you doing down there?
Me?
Yeah.
So the other fuckers are rowing away.
No, well, we're not rowing away yet, we're gonna wait for you. Like, fuck off.
Oh, that's alright.
You're the only rowing man.
Ah.
Well, you have to take the tent down first as well. It blocks the rubber two oars that are secured inside the thing. It sort of folds up. The oars become the poles over like this.
Fair enough. I'll kind of I'll go up to the back of the boat and stay in the water and kick.
What, like the fucking cunt from The Incredibles?
Yes. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
But not
a star. So you're all doing this then?
Yep. Just dismantling boat, handing out oars, and fuck this noise.
It's very, very quiet beyond the thudding at night.
Good.
The sea is almost completely still beyond your shit. You feel very, very noisy.
If the captain's still rowing, I'm still rowing.
Okay.
I just wish to, like, stop rowing for a moment and just listen.
Fair enough, then. Splash, splash, okay.
You stop rowing for a moment, listen. You've gotten a bit away from the thing. You sort of see the green glow pulsating slightly inside the windows. There's sort of a creaking sound. Aside from the thudding.
Hmm.
And there's a crack.
There's a what?
There's a crack. Something makes it a large crack, as if someone split a boulder.
And where
from?
From
underwater?
Yeah, from where you were coming from. And you sort of see the green... the green sort of get more...
intense?
It becomes brighter. And you can sort of see something shedding away from it.
Okay.
Where's this thing that shed away from it, can we see where it's going?
It's just falling down into the deep.
Oh, is it the...
So there's the glow, and then there's something that's come off of it.
Well, considering the glow was coming from inside these three... these three windows, yeah, it's pretty... You're pretty sure it's the boat that's come apart and slid down.
But the glow's still there, or the glow's actually disappearing?
The glow's still there, and very bright. Much brighter now.
Ah. Okay.
I look over at Dunsten and ask him if he actually saw anything whilst he was swimming around in the water.
Well, he saw the arse of the boat, didn't he?
Yes. He was swimming around the boat, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. but you didn't see anything specific.
No, except that the thudding seemed to be coming from very deep underwater.
Right. Yeah, and it's a thudding you've heard before.
Oh, it is.
Sometimes when you haven't been able to sleep too much, some nights it happens, some nights it doesn't. You're not always sure. The green's new,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, well.
The green's new, though. It's very bright. It looks like just this one speck of light, like a star, if you knew what that was, underneath the water, where the boat used to be.
Captain, may I suggest we leave very, very, very quickly?
Well, it's not anywhere near us, though, and it seems like we're back to normal water
Dunsten,
now.
Dunsten, incredibly bizarre shit is happening, and I am outside. This is so far out of my comfort zone, it's practically in orbit.
I tell
feeling
Dunsten,
quite comfortable in the water at that, so...
I say to Dunsten that he should probably get back in the boat, and then we'll just take turns, someone keep awake. If anything does go wrong, then we'll, you know, start fucking off, but for now, we're safe where we are.
Friggin' right. Kind of swallows what he was about to say.
Man's got instincts and beliefs.
Would it make you feel better if we stuck the tent back up?
I slapped Dunsten across the face with being a cheeky cunt.
Okay, so what's going on, man?
No, right, I'm saying we stay put, keep a man on watch, and just see how things go.
We'll take turns being on watch.
I dislike being so loud in the dead of night.
Okay, so who takes first watch? You're all back in the boat. You've set the thing up now.
I've rested, so I might as well take first watch.
Okay, you take first watch.
I nap holding my fucking spear.
It's very difficult for you to wake the others when it becomes their turn. As if the sort of the slow thumping just keeps them asleep. You're having a lot of trouble waking them.
It's the thumping's job to keep us asleep, is it?
And you're very tired yourself.
Oh, Meg, this isn't good.
Do a obs to will.
Obs to will. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait, that's 4, isn't it? Yeah.
Yep.
Hey, just.
You just managed to stay awake.
That's a routine, isn't it? Oh, actually, no, that's not even anything worth marking.
Sadly. Could have made it harder, but you'd be asleep.
No, that's fair. thank you. Right,
Dunsten's closest to you, so Dunsten, roll a will.
Oh, no, I was going to quickly do something. If Dunsten's not waking the fuck up, I'm going to do something painful to him.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Just, oh, shitter, wake up and use my torturing expertise to wake him the fuck up.
Okay.
Clamp his nipples.
Well, Dunsten. Okay, do your torture shit,
just
then.
Just flick his bollocks.
Do your torture shit.
Mother Hubbard. What's the obs on torturing?
The obs is Dunstan's health.
Five.
Obs 5? Son of a bitch.
No. Whatever he rolls with his health.
Oh, fair enough.
Oh, I see.
Fort.
Fort. What's my fort? Yes.
Roll badly.
Can you move slightly closer to the microphone or something? Yeah, you don't wake him up.
Oh,
you
God.
Pinch his ear, but it doesn't work.
What about me?
I thought he was going to flick my bollocks.
He's not trying to wake you, is he, Ollie? You're a little low still, Jeeves, volume-wise. The problem is, all of you are on the same audio track, so if I turn you up, the others will be massively loud. I can't individually adjust the volume, so maybe move a little closer to the microphone or something.
Try twiddling the gain as well.
There you go, there you are.
Is that better?
Yes.
Excellent.
So what's the rule with opposed rolls? Do I still mark that as a check if I did it against someone else?
Yeah, sure. It's the difficulty whatever he rolled against your thing.
Just 5. Was it? 4.
No. The difficulty is whatever. Okay. You rolled. No, it's the obs is what his success is, not what he rolled.
And you got success 4, wasn't it?
So it'd be difficult.
Yes. I'll just say yes, because I forgot what he rolled.
You got 4.
Okay, so, alright. You piss.
I piss absolutely everywhere. Oh, God.
It's okay. everyone.
Yeah, fair enough. If Dunsten has woken up, it's going to be like, oh, shit. And just, as politely as possible, flick Ollie in the bollocks.
Tivium.
Okay, so you flick Ollie. Is that your torture again?
Yes.
Give that another spin, but you've already used it, so it's not going
to... I'm not expecting this is going to grind it. I'm just expecting
Do a fort, Ollie.
Yeah.
Obs 1.
Obs 1 to...
No, wait, it's not Obs 1. It's, you're the Obs. Manage to wake anyone. They're too fast asleep. Normally, this wouldn't be as retarded, but this is not...
No, this is supernatural immunity to bollock flicking. Or something.
You feel very alone.
Oh, man. And we forced him to stay out here as well.
Brigo just kind of bundles up into a ball and starts mumbling about his aunt.
Oh, auntie, auntie.
Auntie.
Eventually it becomes day.
What's going on?
They wake up very well rested. You feel like a sack of shit.
I ask him what the fuck happened to him.
Molly?
Yes.
Roll your health.
My health?
Yes. Oh shit, you wake up and your bollocks are sore.
Ugh, okay. The light wound you took earlier doesn't go away.
Okay.
All right, away. That means everything you do gets an extra obstacle.
Okay.
Oh, you need to remind me of that because I'm a cunt. What?
That's fine.
That was when you were trying to get into the boat, wasn't it?
Yeah.
GM screen, there we go. Let's have a look here.
I got it written out. Okay.
Yeah, we just need to have a look here. Preferred counting. That's a big picture of the lady. That's not what I wanted to look at. I forget. I think it's something hours. So let's say 4 hours and it's okay again.
Right.
I could look up in the book, but I can't be asked. Plus one obs. Oh, good man. Okay, yeah, the green light's gone, the thumping's gone, sun's bright again. You two wake, nice and fresh. Sawbones feels like a beaten sack of shit.
Hooray!
He didn't just...
telling to get some fucking rest. He looks
It's not just normal, haven't slept. It's sort of like he feels like someone had their way with his skull.
No one likes skull fucking. So unprofessional.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm just kind of giving you this 1,000-yard stare of, why wouldn't you wake up?
Are you,
Why didn't you wake us up for our shifts?
You wouldn't wake up. You just lay there.
I give him a quizzical look and just shrug if you say so.
Do you point out where you poked them, or are you going to leave that?
I'm going to omit the fact that they mildly tortured them.
You're not, or you are?
I'm not mentioning that shit. If they don't notice, it's cool.
Well, they don't sort of
I wonder why my bollocks are sore.
I get up and stretch my legs and realise I can only walk like a penguin.
Both of you assume that some adrenaline shit happened last night and you hurt yourself but didn't realise and now it's sore.
You've both got groin strains.
Yeah. It's all the rowing.
Yeah, it's true. Okay, so you're about 50 metres away from where the thing is, or was, rather. It's the next day. What up? We're going to do 15 more minutes, by the way, so we get to 2 hours exactly, so...
I vote we row back and hand in our shit.
This sounds like a good idea.
I want to go back to the wreck.
You want to go back to the wreck? You want to go hand in? Are you going to do all the wits?
Yeah.
No, wait, I said we had 15 minutes.
Yeah, that's
shit.
I was about to say. Right. So, I quickly question, why do you want to go back to the wreck?
So we can get more shit. And I'm interested to see how deep it is now as well.
Also, you didn't really see what happened there, so you're unsure whether or not that was what fell down, or if it's still there and it's pointless going back and saying, yeah, it was fantastic, it's gone.
Okay, I vote that we go back, we see if it's still there or what is still there.
You're the captain.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Captain, you get to make the rules.
Exactly, but then people are giving me their viewpoints, so I'm saying what we'll do is we'll go back, we'll check if it's there. If it's there, awesome, we'll report. If it's not, then we'll hand in the trinkets we get and say it fucked off in the night.
Let's hope they believe us.
Fuck top fuck. In the... Yeah. We just found a small card. Later, bitches.
It's like, I got this car radio, but the car fucked off in the night. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, fence.
I have a feeling they might not believe us, but...
No, that is totally legit. They'll completely believe us.
Okay. So you roll back. Please stop that. It's very noisy.
Sorry.
So you roll back and have a look?
Sorry, I'm just watching this man rotate his dice. So yes, roll back and have a look.
Are you going to send a kid down? It's deep again now.
Yeah, get the fuck in the fucking water.
Is this a new scene, by the way?
It is a new scene. It's a new day, a new scene. Everyone's happy.
Didn't you have a
fucking traumatized.
Anyone have a what?
I'm going to say, didn't we have a water skin floating? Where
yeah, that was at the end of the rope, keeping it up.
Yeah, it's gone.
Is the water skin there? It's gone.
Oh, shit.
Well, we know roughly where it was, so...
If it's gone underwater, I'm assuming it's gone.
Well, yeah. Are you going in?
Yeah.
You chuck the kid overboard.
Just whang him in.
Do your usual swimming. Good man.
Nice.
Annoyed man.
So that's a whole breath plus one if you want, and it's a two to get down there.
Whole breath two plus one.
Getting down the blue. IBS is a terrible affliction.
It is.
Well, last shit.
Ah, fuck. One, dice. Two, three.
Last dice? Where's it gone?
It's here. It's a two.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Well, it takes you a while, but you get down there.
Oh, that's good.
There's a lot of diving back and forth, and the others are getting a little annoyed. Assume, but when you get down there, you see the thing's gone completely. So what's happened is that it slid down here, and it's ripped up this rock formation that was there, and there seems to be this underneath is sort of flaked off. There seems to be this weird sort of inscribed type stone underneath. Seems like there was a structure there covered by whatever it was.
No.
Aya Cthulhu.
There's this...
Do we roll sanity?
No, you don't roll sanity. There's this... At the tip of it, what you assume was what was glowing, there's this weird thing. It's sort of like... It's a cube sort of built on here. Build on the thing, and it's got all these weird things. It's interlocked in itself.
Oh.
But it seems to just be standing there.
Like a big sort of 3D puzzle.
Yeah.
Can we take a bit of it?
Yeah.
Better to ask, can Dunsten grab a piece of it?
Well, I was going to say, I'm assuming that all of this is too heavy for me to move.
Oh,
it's not that big. It's about the size of the box in Hellraiser.
Without necessarily foreshadowing anything bad at all. Fucking hell.
It's slightly larger.
No, I've never seen
it's
that.
Slightly
film
smaller
either,
than Jason Voorhees' head.
Yes. You know, it's about, I don't know, I don't fucking know, a small log? That doesn't mean anything.
In comparison to Lloyd's turd, how is it?
Oh god, no, it's all like a small bucket.
Okay, so I can attempt to bring the whole thing back up.
Yeah, you eventually manage it. The rope was gone, but it was a little irritating. You get it up and you sort of plop it down in the boat. It looks
and
just
I
like
haven't...
stone. Sorry. It's very, very smooth.
While I was down there, I didn't happen to see the end of the rope, end of my rope and the buoy.
No, it's gone. But where this thing has dragged along there was a lot more of sort of similar type architecture visible, dragged off into the deep. But you got this thing now.
And so can I fuck around with it, take it apart?
Give it a
get onto the fucking boat first.
Would you? I thought you'd gone back up though.
Sorry. Oh, fair enough. You brought this back up.
If not, yeah, and then we go back up. Would you two like to homo the oars, please?
It looks very smooth. You had to have a very, very close look to see that there were actually patterns in it. Otherwise, it just looks like a completely smooth box.
So right, when I try to
start rowing back,
what?
When I'm pulling at it, does it come apart at all?
No, nothing happens. It's very smooth.
My fingernails in there.
No, it's very difficult for you to do anything. It's very smooth, and your hands slide around on it, and you can't get your fingernails in the little things. They're simply too fine. You can just see them because it's been underwater, so there's slight grime in them, but your fingernails are too thick to fit in there.
And it's too large to use as a novelty butt plug.
Yeah, a little bit too big.
I don't want to be on this island anymore. These people are strange.
With someone with your anal expertise at your current age,
yes,
calculating
I do have the lithe trait with that.
Calculating prolapse factor, I think no.
Okay, fair enough. Let's move on.
Anyway, I have rolled for my fucking rowing, so we start rowing back.
Ollie's just off.
Fuck the artifact.
Is wrong. Yeah, you get back to port.
Meh.
The man is sort of. He's like, fucking, what happened?
I suppose we tell him then. Do we tell him the truth? That's something else we should discuss on the way home is, do we tell him the truth, or do we just tell him there was a ship under there and it slid down and revealed all this stuff?
We tell them the
truth. I vote to tell him the truth.
The truth,
okay,
obviously.
We'll tell him the whole truth then.
Okay.
We get back.
Okay, one of you explain it to me as the man.
As I'm handing him back, as I'm handing him like the various trinkets and baubles and shit that we've picked up, I mentioned we found this big thing made of metal underneath. I believe it was a ship of some sort underneath the water.
His eyes like up at metal. Metal? What? Where?
As I said, back there. So we managed to find an entryway, and that's where we found all these little things.
Where's the metal? Where's the metal now?
We have some pieces of metal.
He looks at the chains. It's like, looks them over. Thinks that that's probably okay. He puts them in his little bag.
Right, so
some kind of rope,
is,
I think.
Yeah, I mentioned that during the night, as some, the other two were sleeping,
he squints,
we saw
as
like,
you mentioned that you have knowledge of something that happened during the night.
I didn't feel like sleeping, and as it got night, there was a strange thumping sound, and there was green light coming from the wind from the open areas of this metal ship.
He looks sort of very aghast at the fact that you were even awake and looking at things and not just hiding in the fetal position. Like,
mentioned that we heard a horrible like snapping sound at which point.
Stop, kid, just. Keep your fucking rock. Here's some shit. He gives you these trading credits because there's like 100% barter system in this, so you get to keep one of the chains between you because it can be broken up. And he takes the rest and fucks off, and he goes sort of, I don't want that rock. It's pointless. It's not metal. It's not wood. Plenty of rock. And here, live on. I don't want to know what happened at night. Fuck. And he just gets out of there.
Okay.
He's not very. He doesn't want to get involved with night shit.
This was the man who put Fricko on the boat, right?
This was the man that lent the boat. The other guy that made sure Fricko was on
cousin.
The boat was not there. Was this your cousin? No, this was
yeah,
the
I
guy.
So.
This was the guy with the job. It's not Pigskin. Pigskin's drunk.
Oh, okay.
He just lent the boat. So you have to divide the chain into various things. It's like a true barter system here, so anything of value, you change the thing for value. There's not really coins. So having a bit of chain will, in your cases, translate as having cash. So to your gear, add one resource point cash. And a bit of this, of course, goes to Uncle Pigskin, because he lent the boat. And that'll be it for this. You get to keep the box.
Woo! Mysterious butt plug of destiny.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
and a bit.
But we still have to explain to your torturer friends what happened.
They seem to be more interested in seeing him off than having him back. I think he's just expected to come back and behave after this. But more about that later when I have actually fleshed it out and thought about it and don't just send you off in a boat because I want to avoid plot.
Whatever works.
So yeah, that was it for now. I'm hoping we either this weekend or the next, depending on people.
Yeah.
But let's figure that out. So time for arriving men and time for being here. Now you say goodbye.
See you guys.
Bye-bye.